one of the first questions that we brought up on this conversation was, what is the relationship between the diaspora and Israel's Jews yes. today? And I think for the non-Orthodox Jews, they look at Israel as, at least the Rabbanut and the Haredim, as a religious monopoly of fear-based ideology and politics and religion, in that weird Venn diagram where it all overlaps. And that religion or ideology or politics of fear, it doesn't allow for an open exchange of ideas, and it does lead to young boys throwing dirty diapers and pushing women who just want to read from the Torah at the Kotel, right? And whether you think that should never, ever happen, whether you think that should totally happen, or whether you think it's all a load of crap and they just want to read a scroll of fiction at a wall, like, not the point. But when you have such a closed-off perspective, because you're living in a world of real fear, and if you really translate Yirat Shemaim as a literal Yirah, you have a problem. And look, I know that comes off very harsh, and I don't want to sound like I'm not bashing Orthodoxy. I'm not saying there's something wrong about it. But when it becomes to that point that you've rejected any interaction with modernity, not saying you want to take things on, but you've rejected the possibility you could even have a relationship to something modern. Like I was in Israel last year, and I was renting a phone, and one of the options was a kosher phone, and I didn't understand what that right. meant, right? Yeah. And I accidentally got one, and when I got to Florian Airport, and they're like, "Here's your phone," I'm going through, I'm like, "What kind? Like, you can't do that on the phone," and I had to trade it on the spot because I didn't realize a kosher phone was yeah. so religious folk can't even have access.
Yeah, exactly.
It leads to mixed dancing.
But there's always like this, I saw this video on Facebook, you see like this ultra religious guy whipping with an actual whip, like trying to whip women on the streets of Tel Aviv or something, you know, for being that's not religion, that's mental illness, okay? it's ridiculous. It's like saying, you know, it's, and there's a clear delineation to be made there.